For 3 years in a row, divorce rates around the country have been dropping. That is, until recently, at least here in Shelby County, where filings are up over the last few weeks.
Memphis divorce attorneys Larry and Nick Rice literally wrote the handbook on how not to hire them. And they're with us to reveal the three top things to keep you out of divorce court. Nick, let's start with you. Why the sudden rise? What's your theory on that?
Well, we always get a dip around the holidays. Thanksgiving, it slows down. Mm-hmm. Christmas, it slows down. And then when people realize after the holidays are over, they still want a divorce, we always get that bump in January.
So they look for the rest of my life begins this month, and I want this year to be different. And
you get that with the New Year's resolutions. That also happens, oddly enough, around September. We usually see an uptick.
Why September?
We're programmed from when we're little to think of that as another time. That's when you go back around and start school.
That makes sense.
That's another thing where it's like, this is beginning. Plus, you know, you get the kids out. People with children are always, you know, they want to keep Christmas together, give one last Christmas, or like, we'll wait for the kids to start school. You know, there's always a reason like that.
Okay.
The election looks like it also, so many people, this is our theory, because we had a bigger
now, this should be interesting.
I can't test it out, but it did seem that so many people were nervous about the election, because right after the election occurred, before anything, you know, we could even see the results of what was going to happen with the new president, we started picking up more divorces. Rates started going back up.
Wow.
That is very interesting. Now, Larry, again, the book has literally been written about about the divorce practices and so forth. What do you pick up here?
One of the things I'd like to say about what Nick's thinking, I think Nick's right, because I've been at this a little longer than Nick has, and we saw divorce rates dip after 9/11, and we saw them dip after the recession. And when both of those happened, people were emotionally afraid. When people are emotionally afraid, they have all the stress they can take, and they cling together.
They don't want to add another stressor.
Exactly right.
So you've been married 40-something years, right? 40-plus years?
Yes, ma'am. To my high school sweetheart.
So, what are your three?
And if I say too precisely how many, I'll get in trouble at home.
That's a good thing.
Be careful there, then.
Yeah, you might be revealing or hinting of age. Okay, so what are your three best takeaways to do what you and your wife have been able to do and stay together? Because that's not easy.
Be nice. Find out what your spouse likes and do it. Mm. Okay?
Okay.
And results may vary, but by and large, it's the simple cliche things. Neither my father, who was a lawyer, nor my son is a lawyer, nor in my 40-something years of doing this, have I ever had a woman come in and say, I want a divorce because that so-and-so keeps buying me flowers for no reason all the time. It just makes me so angry.
So be nice.
I have never had, on the other hand, a man come in and say, you know, I got to get this marriage over. We're having sex all the time. She served me these nice dinners. I'm getting out of here. So it's those simple cliche things that are cliche because they're so true.
Right. Okay. Got about a minute left here. Number two, you mentioned number one would be nice. What else do you recommend?
Well, it's all falls under that, and it depends on how much you want to spend on it. You can't get a better return on your relationship dollar than buying flowers for your wife for no reason.
And you can get them at Kroger, for Pete's sake.
You can get them at Kroger.
You don't have to get like
holidays.
Okay.
You spend less than $20, and when you were dating,
if you showed up with Kroger flowers, he would actually be in trouble.
Yeah, that might be.
Mom likes it to be stepped up a little bit.
Oh,
I got you.
Well, after 40 years putting up with him,
she's put in her time. She deserves it.
So basically, it sounds like you're saying be other-centered if your spouse maybe doesn't care about flowers but likes for you to do the dishes.
Well, that's true. No man's ever been shot doing the dishes. but you can, and if you're too cheap to buy flowers, get cards.
Okay.
And if you're too cheap to even buy cards, write a note. I love you on a sticky. Mm-hmm. Put that up on the TV.
It's really as simple as that.
Yeah. Okay. There's a calculator in the back of your head that keeps adding these positive and negative points.
So, Larry, with that in mind, pass me that book, because some of us, we need it more than others.
Fine life.
Thank you very much.
Spare time.
A good read here for sure. Pretty thick.
And if he doesn't get your flowers, you throw that out.
Exactly.
That
should shake things up. Gentlemen.
Stop a 45 and...
We got you. Thank you very much, gentlemen. We appreciate it.